And welcome to the stream! Welcome, welcome, welcome! Today I'm finishing up Control Rumbles. I got it all working on three different platforms. It's all working, and then it's... Rumbles on. I didn't plug this in! What's up, Arcane? Cleaning your room? Your Xmas gifts for yourself arrived today? What'd you get yourself? So today I'm going to be taking all this controller rumble, now that it works on all three platforms, I can go and apply it in the game, like use it in places, like when a bomb goes off, for example, that'll be one of the first places to use controller rumble. I think I got to plug it into that to use the rumble. So what'd you get yourself, Pedro? Oh, there it goes. Now it's rumbling. Cool, okay. So yeah, the next thing I want to do is make it so it works with the bombs. Well, that was weird. The bomb jumped. It moved. It moved really weird. Okay, so bombs. Let's do some control rumble for the bombs. You got the stream? Yay! A Rubik's Cube and a Razer Black Widow Chroma Keyboard? Sweet. Let me take a look at this thing. Oh, it's mechanical, huh? Whoa, sweet! That's awesome! It's got all these colors. That's awesome. Oh, sweet. Check that out, right? You can highlight what keys you're going to be using for a game. Dude, this thing is sweet. Dang, that's awesome. So when a bomb goes off, this will be in mood, explode. We'll set up a little, we want it to happen when, yeah, when any bomb goes off. So this is for enemies, this is for super bombs, this is for regular bombs. What's up, Salad? What's up, Kukuriku? You have Vimin today. Earthquake detected in the Bay Area. Oh, yeah. Now I'm finally hooking it all up. So the Rumble's done on Mac. Rumble's done on Linux and Windows. Everything's all totally supported. I got an option in the game so you can enable it, disable it. The last thing to do is just to hook it up and use it in the places where it's going to be a good place to use Rumble. So I'm starting on bombs right now. Here's where we deal damage. Okay, we'll start here. Oh, what's the rumble? Rumble controller. Oh, sadly, I don't have these. Ah. I thought I had this so it would show me the arguments. Maybe not. Well, okay. Vim. I'm still getting to you, like, finally, still getting comfortable with Vim. Wait a minute. I could just go here. And use control. Oh, what? Okay, so we got player type, attack, hold, release, strength, jitter. All right. So player is K player one. Attack. Gonna be quite a quick attack. Imagine the bomb goes boom and explodes. The whole effect lasts maybe like 2 seconds. No, maybe more like 1 to 1.5 seconds. So it's gonna fade in. The attack's gonna be maybe like quarter to a third of a second. The hold will be like a whole second, and the release will be like maybe a half second. The strength is gonna be really strong. Well, depending on how close you are to the bomb. And then the jitter is also going to be pretty huge. Actually, let's do 0.75 so it can really feel jittery. Okay, let's try that out. Oh, what? Attack, hold, release, strength, jitter. What did I do wrong? Can't see. Oh, so much stuff I've left to do to get Vim to be a usable environment. Oh wait, I don't want the release build. Let's go back to the debug. This morning I did a whole commit though, with just Vim. Didn't have to look anything up. Okay, so what's his error? Oh, undeclared an input? Okay. I know, right? So much manual configuration. Yeah, totally. Yep. Once I get it all settled, like there's only a few things left. I got a sweet command now where I can do like a find in files. So if I want to look for all instances of like has all bits, I wrote my own little grep utility or whatever thing that opens a quick window and does. It's a command called mygrep. And I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. It's fast. So that's one little thing, right? You got to have like a find in files type of feature. And I know I could do that. You could do it the same, just like you could just go like grep, start entering your pattern, enter your global options, say what files you want, right? But that takes forever. You don't want to do that. So I wrote a custom command that does that and then opens a quick window. So, but yeah, manual configuration takes forever, but it's worth it. So yeah, one of the next things I need to do is get the auto complete to work and get like a like that would just happen here where I can get errors so they're shown. Yeah, so what would I do here? If there's an error, I want it to pause. If there's not an error, I want it to just come back right into my code. Elisp, yeah, cool. Finish it up. So what's on your list? What are you trying to do with Emacs at this point? I think you told me you're doing something yesterday. Cool, you got a nice little rumble there. That's a nice gentle rumble with a really slow attack and or especially a slow release. Okay, so that was too long. Yeah, that was definitely too long. Okay, so let's do instead of holding for a whole second, we'll hold for like half a second or something. CMake. Oh, right, CMake ID. Yeah. Nice, good. You gotta be lazy sometimes, especially right now around the holidays. Oh, what, oh yeah, your build script too, yeah. Oh, you're not using CMake yet? Oh, you'd write your own custom build script, that's right. What do you guys, has anybody checked out the Steam sales that are going on? What are you guys getting on sale? Wow, still too long. That needs to be a quick rumble. And I want the strength to be a little lower, depending on if you're farther away from the bomb. So I think we've got the hero somewhere. Yeah, you tempted? Yeah, you got 20 bucks? Nice. I got 20 bucks for my birthday too. Feels like a waste. So I got what did I get? I got some stuff this morning. I bought Owlboy. I'm excited to try that. I've definitely had Owlboy on my list for a while. I also got Cave Story. I heard Cave Story is really good. I also got Antechamber, which I also heard was really, really good, but I don't really play 3D games that much, but I just got it anyways. What else did I get? I got a couple other ones. Oh, Enter the Gungeon. I got Enter the Gungeon because it's so popular and it looks fun. I'm not really a twin stick shooter type of person, but I'm trying to get to be. I'm trying to understand what's so fun about twin stick shooters. And because I have a little experience with Isaac, I feel like I can play Twin Sticks now. So you're saying Cave Story is classic? Oh, but you like the original? Oh yeah. Oh, the original had more low was more lo-fi? Damn it. I wish I could play the original. Okay, so we're gonna get the distance from the player to the bomb. Wait, do we already have distance squared in the same function? Ah, that's another little thing about Vim. I can't see whether variables are defined in this function yet, or whether they're member variables. I like that about Xcode. Yeah, the Steam version's Cave Story Plus. Oh, the original's freeware? Oh, whoa. Okay, so let's make this a vec2 of the bomb's position to the player's position. And we'll make a factor, like a distance factor. So let's see if you're, wait, the maximum distance would be like about half the screen. So float factor equals basically clampf 01. Oh, there you go. Cave Story original. You got antechamber? Nice. Right? Antechamber is only like $2 or $3 right now. So I was like, gotta get it. Dang, cool. Maybe I should try it. Oh, I gotta try this. Oh, he wrote the engine from scratch too? Wow. Oh, wow. That's cool. That's really good to know. Huh. So we're going to clamp F this d squared over the maximum distance squared. We'll just use squared of like about 210. So that'll give us a factor from 0 to 1. If the player is right next to the bomb, this will be 0. So yeah, we gotta make this 1 minus. Okay, and then if the player is 210 pixels approximately away, that'll be a max factor. Let's make that not 210, but actually based on the Y distance. So the screen is about, this needs to be about 120. So if you're about 120 away, it's going to be the lowest. Wait, that. No, let's do 210 because that. Yeah, that'll make it a little bit of a stronger rumble. Okay, so now we've got that. We can just go 1 minus half of the factor. So if we're right next to the bomb, we're going to get a strength of 1. And if we're far away, we're going to get a strength of a half. Kiro Blaster? Genital jousting? What? I gotta check these out. Is that on Steam, Kiro Blaster? Oh, it is. So it's another, is it another platformer? Looks pretty good. Is it similar? It looks similar to Cave Story. Wait, what's NSFW again? Oh. Not safe for work. Is it safe for the stream? Maybe not. Oh, it's stage-based? Uh-huh. Yeah. I'm into the whole story-centric Metroid. Cool. Okay, so that's got a quarter intro. Let's make that faster. And then a faster outro as well. Let's try that. It's a game. It's on Steam. I'll have to check that out later. Don't know if it's appropriate. I don't know if I'll get my freaking YouTube video flagged or whatever. They flag you for the littlest things. Okay, I think I won't even, like, zero attack. What if we're away, far away? That didn't really seem like it was too much attenuated. Okay, so let's turn the attack down to zero. And yeah, let's last for a half second, fade out for an eighth of a second. Oh, there's a lot of jitter, so that could definitely affect. Let's turn the jitter down a little bit. It's super funny, cool. Did not feel the difference there. Let's give it a little NIMS debug alert, string with format. See what this factor is turning out to be. Runtime. We're all the way across here. Zero. Yeah, it was. So wait, maybe it's just not enough factor. I just want you to be, I want you to barely feel the rumble when the bomb is across the screen. But so far, it feels like about the same rumble. Was barely there. Oh, wait. So the factor is 1.0. Oh, okay. I had this wrong. Let's make that 80%. Yeah, I'm trying to make it feel, I mean, this is a really great way to communicate with players, especially the players that are kinesthetic. Yeah. I think of it like visuals are one way to communicate with the player, sound is one way to communicate with the player, but tactile things like this, kinesthetic things like this, are another way to connect with people that are, like myself, that are very kinesthetic people. Right? You getting that feeling? I know that feeling. There we go. Okay, so we go across the screen. This should be weaker. Yes! Oh, that felt good. It was just it's like barely there. And here. It's a strong rumble. Alright, that works. What if we could start playing this with some enemies? Okay, so now when the player loses some health, that should be another time to like get some rumble. Where's Jib? Jib, what are you doing? Okay, that's good. Good start. We got rumble. Okay, so let's yank that line and go to change HP. No. We're going to go to on hurt. You're a big fan of rumble? It's in Star Fox, right? Star Fox. Oh, and I got the option too, so you can enable Rumble or disable it in the settings, because Teak was mentioning that. It's really important to him to be able to disable Rumble, because his hand gets numb. He's got an injury. Here it is. We're sleep if you're damaging the player. This is what we want to add a little bit of Rumble here. So we're going to rumble player one. I'm thinking this is going to be a very slight rumble. Very quick, too. We're only at about a third of a second. Oh, and it would be nice if the strength was based on how much damage you take. So if you take a lot of damage, that's HP delta. If your HP delta is like greater than one, we'll make this a really strong rumble. What library? I'm using a gamepad library called OIS, but it didn't have all of the rumble written for it. However, I found some great example code from SDL. SDL's coverage of Rumble is amazing. So anyways, I took a lot of I used SDL's stuff as an example because I had to write all the stuff for Mac. Windows was almost written. I had to write just a couple lines of code for that. Linux was written, but it's not entirely supported. But here it is. It's github.com OIS. But I do recommend checking out SDL because that their library is complete and it's freaking awesome and it has tons of great examples and you can just download SDL and it works on the first try. So yeah. Okay, so yeah, let's make it a rumble factor. You've been looking through SDL? Yeah, it's a big engine, but it compiles so quick. Compared to Cocos 2DX, Cocos 2DX is freaking so bloated and huge. SDL's nice and tiny compared to Cocos 2DX. So we'll make a clamp. We'll clamp FO1 from. Okay, so if we have. We'll make a float out of HP delta. Wait, we'll make a fabs. Uh, out of HP Delta and divide it by, okay, life per container. So if we do an entire heart of damage, that's going to be maximum damage factor. Right, oh, that's a good point. I forgot to see. Yeah, that's why it's so wicked fast to compile. I love that. It made me almost want to switch my entire game to use SDL. I'm like, look how fast this compiles. But I'm sure there's things that Cocos 2DX has that SDL doesn't. Like, for example, shaders. I ran their shader test and it just didn't work. And I'm like, the shaders don't work. You know, maybe it was just their test was written wrong. I don't know. But, okay, so we're going to have a 1.0 if... if the damage is one or is a whole heart. Okay, so let's make this at least a quarter strength plus 3/4 strength times the factor. So if you get hurt a lot, you're gonna get a lot of rumble. And let's go back. I wish there was an easier way to go back and forth. In Vim, I haven't figured it out yet. I know you can jump to your last edit position, but I'm pretty sure that's specific to a certain file. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. So there, yeah, now we see how strong it is. All right, let's do this. Now, every time the player gets hurt, we should get a little rumble. Buffers and tags. Yeah, I know I can use tags. I'm already using buffers. But I mean, Oh, do I need to include input.h in this file? I'm already using buffers. I know a little bit about how to use tags. But I know that Vim automatically keeps... I think it's an automatic tag or something like that of your last edit position. And the last edit position, it works, but I think it only works in the same file. So if you like this, if I want to go back to that last position I was just editing at, it's backtick dot. It's not back. Now it doesn't work. Maybe it's go. Semicolon. There it is. Go semicolon. Yeah, G semicolon takes you back to your last edit. And then I think G comma takes you to the, yeah. Yeah, so G semicolon and G comma. But I don't think those work across files. Or across buffers, whatever you want to consider those. I wonder if that saved the file there. One warning. Oh. Huh. Yeah, I'll figure it out eventually, and then I'm still getting used to all the little things in Vim. Nice. I'm getting a little rumble. It's a very quick little rumble. I want to get a stronger rumble. How would I damage myself more? That was cool. Yeah, that was a 75. I think it's working. Split view? I don't know. I'm not using split view because I prefer this the way iTerm works. It's got this you can get an alternate thing going. So the thing is, Yeah, I know. I tried it. I tried it. I tried tabs. I tried the split view, and I don't like them because you can't change. You can only have one list of buffers. So, for example, on this view over here, I have just these five different data files, right? These five buffers, and I want them to always be like that. So, no matter whether you're using tabs or split view or whatever in Vim, there's only one list of buffers. You can't say, and I would love it if Vim had the ability, like if you had opened up a different tab and you could have different buffers in that different tab, but it doesn't work that way. So that's why I prefer to use this, these two different, they basically split the view of iTerm. Oh, right, yeah, lazy shark, right. Yeah, that's a good, thank you for that. I forgot that you can do marks across files, but the thing is, I want to just go to wherever I was last editing, not necessarily having to set a mark and then go back to it. You know what I mean? Maybe I just need to improve my workflow and actually start setting marks everywhere. Like whenever I start editing some code, I can like place a mark right here. That actually sounds like a pretty good idea. That might be a good habit to get into. But I wish it was just more automatic, you know? What's Control D do? So let's turn off this boss. Oh, control the split view. So I wanna see if I can get some strong amount of damage to the player. First boss does. Yeah, I'm using our iTerm 2, which has pretty nice support for the whole split view thing. Oh, wrong world. So I think the first boss, when he does his hammer, it does a whole heart of damage. Let's see if that's true. Take a look at his AI. Something's wrong. We're looking at drop boss. His AI, he's got this one sequence called Hammer Time. If target any, if target near, if ran smart. Oh, he does a pretty low random roll, but it might be ran smart. Because he's in dungeon one, which makes his smart, his intelligence, pretty low. So it might have been that. Might have been it never got the random smart roll. Oh, there he goes. Nice, it was that. Do it again. Yeah, oh, there we go, cool. Yeah, that was 100% shake. Cool. That feels pretty good. It's a nice, strong shake. Good rumble. Oh, control log. Oh, does it? Let me try that out. Cool, that works great. Nice, and I like that change to this guy's AI. Probably just, okay, let's try it right now. I wanna go back to that C++ file I was in. Control O is back, right? Control I is forward. Oh, dude, it works. Oh, that's awesome. It even jumps to the same point in the same file. That's great.
Okay.
Yeah?
I'm gonna go ahead and eat, okay?
Oh, where are you? Is Donnie ready?
It'll
be ready for you when you're done. Right. But I'm just having easy mode today. Okay. I'm sorry. Smells good. Okay. Lazy Shark, you're my hero. So let me try that with Control-I. Yes, it works across files! Oh my god, that's so awesome! It's a lot better than G. Oh, and you can, oh, jump list? Oh, what? Did I type it wrong? Jump, whoops. It's called jump list, right? I've seen that before. Oh, jumps. Okay. Oh, those are edits I made. Jump number 71. Oh, so 0 is the last edit I just made. Oh, interesting, it's relative too. So it's showing me 0 is where I was at in the jump list, and then 3 is like 3 ahead, and that's like -3 or whatever, right here. Jumps, cool, I gotta remember that. Nice, thank you, man. Oh, yes. Let me just do some muscle memory to try to remember this. So I want to go forward, control I. I want to go backwards, control O. That's so great. I might even map that to my, I got some keys that, I don't know if I'll do that. So great. That's a cool one. Oh, does anybody know? You know how you do, like, if I get a quick window open here, you control W invokes like the window commands or whatever. So if I want to do like a search, I'll use my my grep command, whatever. So right, and I do control W K goes up to this window, and control W J goes back to this window. Is there like an alternate key besides control W to initiate those commands? I know I could write a custom one into my vimrc, but I find control W to just be kind of a cumbersome thing to type for such a thing that I would use so often. So I'm just wondering if there's an alternate way to do that. I'm sure there's got to be some way in Vim that you're meant to do that without control. Yay, Rocket, nice, man. What are you gonna do now? Okay, let's try that one more time. 0.25 plus 0.75 times factor with the randomness of 0.5 jitter. That's feeling pretty good, actually. Wait, maybe it could have a little bit more release. If you get hit really hard. Let's try that. What's up, Madge? Mage? Mad Getter? Working on controller rumble. So let's go up here. I'll get hurt like barely by hitting him. Did a tiny rumble. Now I want to get hit by his hammer, and I'll get hurt a lot. Yeah, that was alright. That's good. Yeah. Cool. That's good. So that's all I did there was just add a tiny bit more factor or release time when you get hit really hard. And that felt pretty good. No, I'm not using TMUX. I'm using the built-in feature of iTerm where you can split your pane. And I kind of prefer that because I love how it does that and lights up which pane is being used. I know TMUX probably has that feature too. It's just, I don't know, I'm already using this. Thanks, man. I appreciate you saying that. Okay, so where else do I want? Oh, low health. When you have low health, I want it to rumble the controller a little bit each time the screen does its effect. So let's yank here, and I think it's an in. Oh, let's use my grab command. I want to look for anims hurt. There's a couple places I'm doing that. One's here and here. Oh yeah, you use Control W. Yeah. Oh, you can do leader as well. I'll probably just map it to something. I want to do some kind of map so it's just not quite as hard to press the control. Yeah, leader keys are great, right? I need a good leader key. What do you guys set your leader keys to? So maybe it's this one. Yeah, this is the low health. Nice guess. All right, so if we got tick mod ticks per second equals this. Yeah, so this is doing an anims hurt when whenever you have low health, it's just constantly blinking the screen red. Use a space bar. Oh, space bar. Now that's a cool leader. I didn't even think about how space bar could be a leader key. You use comma? Nice, Lazy. You've been playing with Space Max too. What's your opinion of Space Max? Tell me what you think. Both you guys, I'd love to hear. What do you think of Salad now that you've been switched to Emacs for a while? Okay, so whenever there's a little bit of, when you're almost dead, we just want to barely rumble. There's no factor. Oops, I want to delete to the comma. There we go. Okay, yeah, so barely do a rumble too. But with a lot of jitter. I want this to be one of the most jittery rumbles of them all. Let's try that out. Let's get hurt. You like caps lock? Yeah, you stay on the home row that way. Caps lock I use for escape though. Nice, you're loving Space Max, right on. Yeah, sweet. instead. See a little bit better. Let's go to the home the overworld for this. Hold on, I'm just suddenly bugged by this. Yeah, let's go to the overworld. Oops. You like Space Max? It's getting sluggish now and then. Yeah, nice. Yeah, Mad Getter, the game is 60, 120, 240, or max. You can even max it out as long as you turn off your VSync. But I'm running it, I'm running this stream at 15 frames a second because my internet's really limited. So, I have to limit the game to 30 frames a second on my computer just so I can stream and play the game, which kind of, you know, it's kind of sucks, but like, yeah, so you're seeing it at 15 frames a second. I'm seeing it at 30, but when I normally play the game, I play at 60. And when you play on Windows, you can turn off your VSync and play at maximum FPS or whatever you want. Okay, so I'm going back to the home world or the home screen, the overworld. Let's go to 7. Now let's go to 640, see where that takes us. So I'll need to get hurt a little bit from some enemies. Yeah. You have to turn off your VSync though for it to do more than 60. Okay, so there, that's a good situation. I'm low on health. And it's just barely rumbling. Honestly, it's not enough. It needs to be a little more rumble. It's too slight. Let's turn on initial hurt so that I can just start with the low health. And let's make it a little bit more rumble. So the time was okay, but this was just too little. Maybe it's 0.5 plus another quarter times the randf. Oh, one. So that's a little bit random. Yeah, all you gotta do is write a good tick, a good game tick, and you can run your game at whatever frame rate you want. There's a great article from Glenn. I'll point a link to the article here in a second. That's better, yeah. I think I want it to be even random on its time, though. But yeah, if anybody's interested, and you know, you're interested in writing games and stuff, write your game tick so it's flexible. And it's a great article from Gafferon Games, Fix Your Time Step. Excellent article. I recommend this. This is like game development 101. This is one of the most important things you can do, is write a good game tick. It's basically just how this is bad. Doing your game with a fixed, or with a not with a fixed delta time, but like a with a flexible delta time. If you're writing your game tick and you're using a flexible delta time, you're setting your whole game up for a world where it's just gonna break like crazy. You won't ever be able to do a flexible game tick that way. Anyways, okay, so let's do a little bit of randomness on the time. So I'm thinking this could be 1, 2, 5 plus another 2, 5. Same release. And maybe this should be like a third plus. No, wait, what was that before? That was 2, 5 up to 3 point. A third plus a third, basically. So that'll change the range from. Or it was a half plus a. What was it? Shit. Forget what it just was. A half plus a quarter. So that's 0.5 to 0.75. Yeah, I want it to go lower. So yeah. Let's try just 0.3 plus up to 0.8. So then another 0.5. With a lot of jitter. So the low end is a little too low, and the high end's a bit too high. So 0.3 is too low. Let's do 0.4 then. And it was up to 0.8, so let's take that down to 0.7. And it seems like it was a little bit too long that time. So let's make the random duration about like that. And it would be nice if I could start it just a little bit before the hurt animation runs. It would feel really cool, I think, if this started just ever so slightly before. The other one. So like ticks per second times maybe, let's try it, not a tenth. Ticks per second, so this is about a second long. Yeah, let's try a tenth first. So that'll make it, the rumble will start just a barely before the sound starts. Ooh, that's just a tiny bit too soon. But it feels cool. It's a good start. Let's make that 0.75. That'll happen about 20th of a second later. It's that warning. Now it's still feeling too soon. Kind of feels weird. Is the audience here mostly game devs? Oh, watching this stream? Yeah, mostly. I would assume, I don't know. I guess we've never taken a straw poll. Okay, let's do a straw poll. Never done this before. Not sure how many people are watching today or what, but I'm interested in seeing. Two votes for game dev. Where am I getting this warning at? Yeah, that's what I meant to do. Sometimes, man. I don't like that warning. I don't like you, warning. Okay, so I up that just a tiny bit more. Try now. One that definitely needs a little more tweaking. I'm wondering if 775 feels about right, but I'm wondering now if maybe a little bit of delay after might even be cool. or what's the difference? It's a difficult thing to feel. It's so subtle. And it definitely should go higher. Weird. It actually feels better with it delayed a little bit after the sound. Too short of a duration for you to even feel. It's like the low ones are too low still, even though it's using a 0.5 strength minimum. Let's try a little more duration there. 5 votes, all game devs. What's up, game devs? So I'm working on controller rumble, just implementing it, putting it all in the game. Yeah, this feels a little too much now. Okay, we'll go back to the 1, 2, 5. I think that's going to be good enough for now. I guess we could try a little bit even more delay here. See how that feels. But I like that 0.83. That was pretty good. Yeah, that's just slightly too delayed. Cool. Get back to there. All right, cool. We got some good. What else would be a good place in the game to put some controller rumble? I'm gonna check this in so far though. So we do rumble whenever a bomb goes off. Oh, I should check what happens with the super bombs. We do a rumble whenever you get hurt, and we do a rumble whenever you are low on health. I think it's a pretty good start. And also, there's a big rumble when you open up the boss doors. Maybe there should be some more things like that. Let's check the bombs. Oh, I hate it when this happens. Make sure I got super bombs. Don't got super bombs. It's a good thing to have. And let's go somewhere else. Sorry, Jib. That felt good, but it needed more. Let's go back to Mood Explode. Whoops. And if it's a super bomb, it needs a longer duration. You can solve the Rubik's Cube in under 3 minutes. Oh, right on, man. Props. Okay, so super explosions, we want to do mostly strong, not as much jitter. A good whole second and a half, plus a nice long outro too. World record, 4.6 seconds. Are you kidding me? What? Solve a Rubik's Cube in under 5 seconds? Alright, needs to last a little longer. Maybe a longer outro as well. And let's add a whole second to that. Yes, that's feeling pretty good, but a little bit less here and more jitter. Big difference. Rubik's Cube world record. What? Holy crap. That's amazing. I didn't know the world record was that. Was like that, man. That's amazing. You see how fast his fingers were moving? His fingers were blurry. Man, respect. A little less hold. Good. I like it. The bomb got stopped by the dialogue. Good. I like that. Where are some other... Oh, I know. We could do when the... this one statue thing falls over. So we have Jib. We go to dungeon 2, or wait, no, this is, I think I know where this is. Sebsa, what's up, man? How you been? Right, isn't it? Oh, this is it. Sweet. Okay, so I want a little bit of controller rumble when that thing falls and hits the ground. It happens, and I think there's a phase. Yeah, phase statue falls. Cancel dialogue, push this Lenzy effect. Yeah, do it right here. Okay, so we want, instantly hit the ground. This is a pretty quick hold, like maybe a half second effect. Fast release, maybe an eighth of a second. Full factor, this is supposed to kind of surprise you. And half jitter. The game dev's going great, man. This game's getting more mature every day. Getting into the final phases of development here, where I'll be telling the final bits of the story, doing the final refinements to the bosses, final refinements to all the enemies, refining all the dungeons, and basically just getting the game closer and closer and ready for release more and more each day. But it's still going to be quite a while till then. Okay, so I'm walking around, I'm coming in here. Oh, it's supposed to happen when it hits the ground, not right when it first starts. Okay, so we got a schedule before tick. I believe it's going to be inside this thing. This is delays 0.942 seconds. Reanimate jib, this thing, skids. Yeah, it's right here. Put it here. Nice, yeah. Will I stream? Yes, I will, man. I will. Depends on what I feel like doing, though. I don't know what I'll want to do. I know eventually I want to do a Songbringer 2 and 3. They might not be called Songbringer 2 and 3, but they'll be the second and third games in the series. Where else is a good place to use these controller rumble? Oh, maybe the... Oh, yeah, bosses. Bosses could use some controller rumble. Like the worm boss when he's coming out of the ground. Good. That was a nice short rumble. Felt pretty good. I liked it. Okay, so let's make a... Now we need to have an effect where an AI can call Rumble. Jib's dance party. I like it. Jib's dance party. So yeah, next I'll do it where the bosses can do a little bit of Rumble. What's the difference between 16 and 32? 32 gets you the game right now. 16 gets you the game when it comes out. So when you order the $32 one, you are immediately sent a Steam key from Humble. So when you order the $16 one, your email gets put on a list, and when the game is finally released, you'll be sent your Steam key. But either one of them gets you your name in the credits, so you're gonna get your name in the credits either way. Oh, let's look at the Drops boss again, and he's got a little bit of when he does his roar. Where is that again? Sound roar. I'm not sure if I want to use it for this guy, actually. He's already got bombs that are going off everywhere, all the time. Let's do this for the worm boss, but we might want to mimic it after... Where? Oh, here it is. Sound taunt screen shake. I guess we'll need to have a new command called Rumble. Okay, yeah, we'll have a Rumble command. All right, so we'll go constants. K behavior. Songbringer fan art, that'd be sweet, man. Oh yeah, no worries, Seb. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. spiral quantity. Here we go. We'll have just a command called rumble. And constants. Okay, so we got rumble as a word now. Now we need to be able to hook it up to... Ooh, let's go backwards in the jump list. What's up, the prince? Thank you, man. Appreciate it. Okay, so I'm going to go backwards. Control-O. I want to go back to the last time I did a rumble, and I'll copy this. Yank. Now I'm going to go forward in the jump list. And this time I'm going to open up AI behavior. Yeah. Lurkers. What's up, lurkers? And there's lots of people that watch the YouTube video, too, when it comes out. Because for a lot of people, this is not their time of, you know, they can't watch the stream right now. Okay, AI system and K behavior. Let's look for behavior screen. It's going to be similar to something like that. And we'll yank 11 lines. Paste. So if we're doing rumble, want a D6J. All right, so we got float valve 1, float valve 2. We're gonna need a lot of float valves here. Float valve 0. And the last thing, how would I go back to the beginning of this function quickly? In Vim. I don't know how to do that. I could just search for behave in reverse. Okay, so to get float val, need a flow valve 4 basically. Okay, let's go back to the last point, control O. Oh, I love that, dude. I love it so much. You started working a bit in C++? Nice, man. With SFML? I don't recommend Cocos 2D over SFML or whatever because you're already using SFML. I really believe this strongly that whatever you gravitate towards with a, when it comes to like an engine, that's, that might be the thing for you. If I were you though, I would give Cocos 2DX a try, and you know, if maybe if it kind of like suits your needs a little bit better, then switch to it. But if not, just keep sticking with SFML. You can also try SDL. SDL is another one that's pretty good. And it also kind of depends on what you want, what kind of game you're making, and what kind of requirements you have for your game. Oh, is it? Nice. So we would need, that's one, two, three, four values. Yeah, so we have to have five values at least to get the fourth index or the fifth index. Okay, now this is something I actually want to debug. You like lightweight? Nice. Yeah, Yeah, Kokos is definitely not lightweight. You can kind of make it lightweight in the sense that you can kind of compile your own library of it. You know, that's what I do. I make sure I compile it all to a lib file, and then I only include that lib file. But it's still a giant lib file. It's like a 100 megabyte lib file. It's definitely not lightweight, and it's just getting more and more bloated because they keep on adding tons and tons of features. What's up, Kofez? Okay, so this I want to debug means I gotta go into Xcode. I'm using Vim keys now. I need to install that one plugin where it makes Xcode work with Vim keys. Okay, let's set a breakpoint here and we'll open up the drop. Wait, not the drop boss, the worm boss. We want to go to the worm boss. Ah, shit. I hate that. The worm boss is at, where the hell? It's like negative 50. I don't even know. I don't even know what dungeon it is in this world. Okay, we gotta find the worm boss. Start with dungeon six, I guess. So I got Rumble hooked up to the boss doors when you get hurt, when bombs go off, when you're low on health. Now I'm hooking it up into the AI system so that, any AI can call a rumble on the player's controller. Here it is. Sweet. Okay, now where is the stairs or the elevator? Oh, here it is. Nice. Yeah, what's up? Ask away. Oh, that is a switch, so must be the. Oh, here it is. Rumble, rumble, rumble. Don't think I got any poison. So we got all set up. Now we gotta go to the worm boss. Yeah. Worm boss. Acid boss, I think he's called. Now, when he's coming out of the ground, I think it's this one right here. Let's go rumble. Intro a half second. Rumble for a second. Outro a half second. Rumble strength a half. And jitter a half. So now we got that hooked up. And we got a breakpoint. Let's see if it acts as it's supposed to. How do you use it with Coco2DX's nodes? Oh, it's pretty easy. I just have Coco2DX's nodes is there's only one entity that ever uses Coco2DX. So most of my game is kind of abstracted away from Coco2DX. And there's only one entity that uses Coco2DX, man. It's just the render component. The render component, and all the render component has is a sprite. I'm using a subclass sprite called Sprite Blend, but that's just a regular sprite. You have your ECS and it's all manual memory managed, and Cocos has automatic memory management, and it's all confused. Oh, just don't use Cocos's automatic memory management. Yeah, I try not to use that ever. So, for example, the render component, you can see right here, it's actually got an instance of a sprite. It's not a sprite pointer, right? So when a new render component is created, it already has created a sprite. It's just already part of this struct, right? And then when I go and when a render component is actually constructed, it just makes sure to call the sprite constructor as well. Where's that at? Oh no, it doesn't even need to because it uses the default sprite constructor, and then it just uses the sprites init function to initialize it. So it either uses sprite.init with sprite frame, or sprite.init with texture, or sprite.init with file. Yeah, I just use a rendering part of Coco2DX. I ignore a lot of Coco2DX's features, which is why it's too much for me. I almost kind of like would like to use a minimized version of Coco2DX or to write my own game engine or something in the future. I'm not sure. Yes, it is. Yes, it is, Salad. It keeps objects around a long time. Like it uses its own form of like Objective-C's auto release most of the time. So you're not guaranteed when or how long some things will stay in memory. You are, of course, if you use your own retain release or whatever with it, or you use its own, you know, a new or whatever. But if you're using its auto release system, I guess it works pretty well because Coco2DX has been around a long time and I've never really had any problems with it, but still, it's its own garbage collection system. No, no, no. You want to add it to the scene. You still want to add it to the scene, right? So yeah, so I've got this sprite is just a member of this class. It's not a pointer. And you call it's init, but when you're done, you're ready to where does it add it? Here it is. So I have a function here that adds it to the scene, right? So I've got one layer where I add all my sprites, and you just call add child when you're ready. Yeah, I prefer to do that myself. I prefer to use new and delete for effects most of the time. But in this case, I'm using a straight up, I don't even have to call new and delete because the delete happens essentially when this render component gets deleted. Yeah. So you don't need to worry about rendering or updating or anything. You use Coco2DX's add child. So I'm still using Coco2DX, but I'm only using it just for this one sprite really. And of course some labels and things like that here and there, but this is the main thing, right? Everything else, every other component. Look how many, there's so many components. There's AI component, attack component, collision component, dialogue, door, exit, gear, health, input. Pretty much all of those don't even use Coco2DX. Shadow component does. Render component does. reflection component does, dialogue component does. So really all I'm using though is sprites, layers, labels, and their actions. I just use BM font for their fonts. So I use the label class and I use a bitmap font. It does stick out like a sore thumb in C++. Yeah. Yeah. You wrote your own memory management and everything. Okay, let's see. We got a breakpoint set. Let's see what happens here. Not really. No. I don't really use the director that much. I use the director for just basically just creating my own game tick. So yeah. I use the director just enough to get a game tick started. So where do I install my tick? Here it is, the setup schedule. So I call the director's schedule update with priority the maximum priority, right? So that my this little class right here gets called this tick scheduler. So it just calls this thing's update, and then this thing's update calls my tick and my animate. So I pretty much am not using their director either. Oh, the big text file? This one here on the right, you mean? This is my saves.txt. This is the game's data. Yeah, and then, right, and then so, oh, you mean this one? This one here on the left, this is actually, yeah, this is Valtry. This is just the entity's AI. Oh no, Code, what's up? What are you doing? Why are you coughing? Mr. Frenick, protein shake. Yo. What's up, man? I'm installing all the uses of controller rumble now. So we got a breakpoint. Let's see what happens with this break or these variables. So we got float 4, float 0. So we got float. The intro is 0.5, 1, 0.5, 0.5, good. And the flow valve 4 should be 0.2.
I just want you to know that dinner is delicious.
Okay, I'm almost done. Thanks, man. Oh, man. You got asthma? Oh, that sucks, dude. You're putting together a devlog? Sweet, man. I'd love to see it. All right, Seb Sub, we'll see you, man. Thank you. Appreciate it. Okay, and float valve 4 is 0.5. Should have made these a little bit more unique. Let's do that. So let's make some of these like 0.3 or something. Let's just call this one 4, 3, and 2. So that's just more obvious. Yeah, 0.4, 0.3, and the last one should be 0.2. Good. Good, good. And we're passing it in 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. So that should work. Now we got Rumble hooked up to the AI system. And I want to undo all these changes. Hey, see you, Pedro. Good night, man. Happy holidays. Why do crisps and salsa taste so good? Salsa's awesome, right? Oh, that was good. That was a good use of Rumble for sure. But it wasn't long. It was a little too long and not enough fade out. So this should be more like, let's do my favorite number and then a good longer fade out. Mr. Freddy. Yeah. It's also fun to say. It's also a fun dance. Okay, that was not quite long enough that time. Let's do do a little more. Is that what it really is? Is that a word? How do you flossinasa pillification? God dang, I think you showed me that word once before. That was a little bit too much rumble on the end there. All right, so this is, I'm almost done with the stream here. My lady just made dinner. I don't want it to get cold. So, but I got a lot of new places where it uses the controller rumble. Yeah, that was good. I like it. But I think that should be point two. Okay. It's your favorite long word? To declare something completely worthless. Oh, what a crazy word to have that means that. All right, so that's going to be it for today's stream. I don't know where else I'll use controller rumble in the game. We got it for when you've been hurt, when you're low on health and it's blinking, when the boss doors open up, when that one statue falls over, when the worm boss comes out of the ground, whenever a bomb goes off. It's even bigger when a super bomb goes off. And I think those are a lot of good uses for now. And along the way, through creating the game over the next few months, I'm sure I'll be putting in Rumble in other places too. So, you declare this. Nice. So, see ya, everybody. Thanks a lot for watching. And I appreciate you all. You're all really great people. I appreciate your views and just chatting and stuff like that. I have fun with you guys. So, we'll see you all next time. Later, later, later.